I'm here 32 meters underground in North London under the Victoria Line, where National Grid has dug 32 kilometers of tunnels and laid high voltage electricity cables that will keep London running over the next 5 decades. This £1 billion London Power Tunnels project is one of the major infrastructure projects in Britain that will help deliver secure and reliable energy in London and support the transition towards a net zero future. The cables stretch 32 kilometres or nearly 20 miles from Hackney in the east to Willesden in the west and from Kensal Green to Wimbledon in the south. This 7-year project to rewire London was officially completed in February 2018 and is one of the most important additions to the capital's electricity system since the 1960s. It's designed to support the UK as it transitions towards a net zero carbon future. With the next decade seeing the London population grow to nearly 10 million, combined with the increase in renewable energy and electric vehicles uptake, as well as the electrification of domestic heating, James Watson, Lead Advanced Commissioning Engineer at National Grid, says demand for power will surge.
We expect electricity demand to at least double. So this is a twofold win for society. It's not just increase the capacity of the system, but it's also allowed us to replace aging infrastructure that served the country well for the last 50 or 60 years and do it in a non-disruptive way. So we have to balance the need to deliver a reliable, sustainable energy network that's fit for 21st century, but at the same time, we also need to work towards the UK government, what I think are global and societal ambitions towards net zero by 2050. And of course, that is going to cost money, and there's no such thing as a free lunch, but we hope that the infrastructure that we're putting in is fit for purpose, reliable, sustainable, and will serve society well for a good many decades to come.
And in the next 3 decades, around 400,000 people will need to be recruited in the energy industry to help the UK meet its 2050 goal. While the challenge continues to get more young people to study STEM subjects and to attract engineers into the sector, people are now increasingly motivated to do a job with purpose, and the energy industry offers just that, says Chief Electricity Engineer David Wright.
What's really interesting about the net zero report is that, you know, 57% of people want to come into the industry and do something to deliver net zero. And we think this is really creating a wave of momentum for the first time for people to come into our industry. And as when people do, we've got huge training capabilities inside National Grid, but all of the other energy companies as well. So it's a real exciting opportunity for us to reskill, retrain people, adults who want to come into the sector, as well as drive that new, you know, skills base that we need moving forward.
And there's been a steady increase in people joining National Grid's graduate scheme, and Sarah is one of them.
You can really have a contribution to net zero, and it's really surprising to hear that only 12% of the workforce are women. There's just such a big opportunity there to really fill the skills and jobs that we need over the next decade. With the net zero ambition and the UK government commitment last year, it's such an opportunity. Now's the time to get involved.
Sarah is also getting involved in the second phase of the 6-year London Power Tunnels project, which is replacing existing electricity cables in South London that are coming towards the end of their life. These projects are creating electricity superhighways that will increase the resilience and robustness of the grid and support the growing demand for power in London, as well as Britain's transition towards net zero carbon over the next 3 decades and beyond. Priyanka Shrestha, Energy Live News, London.